Hello everyone, in today's tutorial we see how to create this glass morphism that you can see in here using Adobe Illustrator. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Okay, so let's go and open Adobe Illustrator and let's go to File, New, and let's create a document using 1920 pixels for the width, 1080 pixels for the height, orientation set to landscape, and we're not gonna mess with any bleeding or anything. And the color mode I will keep is RGB, screen 72, and I'll press OK. Alright, now we have our document. Now let's go and open the image that we'll be using. Let's go with this one and just drag it and open it in Adobe Illustrator. And now we're gonna resize it a little bit, so I'm gonna press Shift Alt or Shift Option, and this will allow me to resize it just like that. And let me make it a little bit bigger using Shift this time only. Yeah, something like that, I think it will work. And let's center it. All right, let me just center it. Okay, so now we have our image in here, and I like actually in Adobe Illustrator, I like actually to name my layers the same as I name my layers in Photoshop. So let's name this base, and then we're gonna create a copy of this. So I'm gonna press Ctrl Command C to make a copy of this layer that I'm selecting, and then I'm gonna press Ctrl Shift or Command Shift V, and this will paste it on place. As you can see, now we have two copies in here, but this one I wanted to make it on top, so I'm gonna create a new layer on top, and I will call this blur, and I will drag this copy that we created and put it in this blur in here. Now we have two separated images in here, one called blur and one called base. Alright, so for you to see, we have two of them. Alright, now we're gonna create a rectangle. So let's select the rectangle tool in here, or you can select the rounded rectangle tool, and let's create a rectangle just like this. Alright, something like that. And we're gonna make these corners round. So I will zoom in and I will take this point in here and I will drag it until I'm happy with the amount of the radius that I have in here. And as you can see, I have this really nice rounder corner in here. All right, now we need to actually apply a blur on the background behind this rectangle. So I will make sure that I'm selecting this image in here. Let me actually make this base image invisible for us not to get confused. All right, so I will make sure that I'm selecting it by one click on this circle in here, and this will make a selection. And then I will go to the appearance in here, and under this effects in here, you can see this effect icon. You can find the blur effects in here and choose Gaussian blur. And you can give it to whatever 20 or 40 radius pixels in here, but for me I will keep it 20. And now we have a blur applied on the image in here, but not the base image. All right, because we have them separately. All right, now for us to actually make this blur inside this rectangle, we need to select them both and make sure that you are selecting the rectangle and then the image under it. You can select the rectangle first, and by pressing Shift you can select the other one, and now we have them both selected. And then we're gonna right click on top of this and we're gonna choose Make Clipping Mask, and you can see now we have a clipping group in here in the layers. Alright, now we have them, we have the blur applied on the rectangle only. Alright, now I want actually to make this rectangle to have some effects. So I'm gonna call it stroke because I want to apply a stroke on it. All right. So for us to apply a stroke, we're gonna go to this gradient in here, and I'm gonna apply a stroke using the gradient. So I will select the stroke in here and apply this gradient in here. And let me just zoom in a little bit. And actually, let's press Ctrl Command H to hide this round in here because I want to see what's going on. All right, so in the gradient in here, we're gonna actually select this color stop first and keep the opacity set to 100, but make sure that the color is set to white using your swatches in here. You can use this color in here. Okay. Make sure that it's set to white and go to the second color stop and also make sure that it's set to white. All right, and then in the second color stop, actually I will put down the opacity to like 20%. All right, and then I will take it and move it just right here, and then I will create another color stop, and this one I will actually make it 20, and then I will go back to this and I will put like 10 in the opacity, and this one I will make it like 20. And now we have like this color go from 20 to 10% to 20 again. And also the angle, I would put it minus 100. All right, I think it looks good. So now if I select the other background, you can see that we have this stroke in here. All right, so we're not done. We're gonna apply some effect on top of this glass that will make it look like a glass. So to do this, I'm actually gonna create a copy of this stroke in here. So I'm gonna take this and create another copy, and I will make it outside of the clipping group, and I will call this gradient. All right, now we have this gradient rectangle, but I need to actually to clear all the appearance that I have in here. So I will open the appearance in here, and I will go in here and I choose clear appearance. Now if I go, I can just make the fill set to white, and you can see we have the same rectangle that we created in the first time we created this rectangle. All right, now I want to actually apply a gradient to the fill this time. So let's open this gradient in here, and by the way, all this that you can see in here, you can find them in the window. If you don't find anything in here, you can just look for it in the windows in here. You can just look for the swatches, the layers, and also the strokes and the gradient. I mean the strokes, it's in the gradient too, so make sure that you are selecting the strokes in here. All right, and this will open the gradient and the transparency. All right, so make sure that you are selecting the gradient layer. And now I will make sure that I'm selecting the fill, not the stroke, and I will apply a gradient in here, as you can see. And let me just delete this middle stop in here. Or actually, let's go back and choose a default gradient in here, or for you not to be confused. All right, now I will select the first color stop, and I will keep the opacity set to 100%, and I will select the second color stop, and I will make sure that the color is set to white because we already have this set to white, we didn't change it. And then I will change the opacity to 0%, and the angle is the same as Photoshop. You can choose whatever angle you want, so it's depend on how where you want the gradient to be. So I think I will put it like minus 102. Yeah, something like that. This will make it go from here. Also, I want this to be a little bit not that strong. So I will take this and put it goes. The transparency, I want it to be closer to the 100% color that we have. So maybe I will go to this middle point in here and I will put it, that's like 35% in here. So let's actually change it to 35, and I will go back to this first car stop and I will change the opacity to 30% for us not to have it that strong. Yeah, I think 30% is good. And let's see before and after. I think it still look very strong for me, so I will go back to the gradient and I will change it to like 10%. And let's change this location back to like 50% or 40%. All right, I think it looks okay. So let's see now. Yeah, I think I like it much, much better like that. Yeah, I think now it looks much better. All right, now we have our blur and our gradient. So the last thing that we want to add is a little bit of noise or grain to add a little bit of this texture. All right, so again, I will create another copy of this rectangle. So I will drag it to this plus icon and this will create another copy. And again, I will select this, let's call it grain. And then I will make sure that it's selected by just one click on this circle in here. As you can see, now we have it selected, or you can select it using your cursor. So I prefer to make sure that selected using the circle. And then I will go to the appearance in here, and then I will clear all appearance. And as you can see, now everything is clear. If I make the fill to 100 to a color, it will be applied on it. All right, so now I want to apply a noise or like a grain. And for us to have a good grain, we're gonna actually change the fill color to a black color, like this one in here. All right, so just open this fill in here that you have, and make sure in here it's set to black. And then in this FX icon, you can go and choose artistic and choose thin grain. As you can see, and this will open, it's just exactly like the filter galleries in Photoshop. All right, so in this film grain, make sure that everything set to 20%, or if you want to experiment with it, you can do that. But if you put down the grain, it will add more of the black, so it's better to set everything to 20% or to the maximum for a better result. All right, now as you can see, it's a little bit strong, so we're gonna actually change this to the opacity of this to like 5% or something. So let's make it like, let's see, like 20% for now to see. And also I want to change the blending mode of this to like overlay or soft light. So let's keep it soft light with like 7% opacity in here. And there we go, we have our texture in here on top as a glass. And now the other thing that I want you to know is, like, for example, if you want to change the placement of this in here, like of this glass morphism that we have in here, if you go and just select it, you can do that. You can move only the rectangles. And for us to move the blur and everything together, you make sure that you are selecting the layer or the rectangle that says stroke with the gradient rectangle using control or shift. Select them all three of them. All right, and then you can go and move them around, and as you can see, the blur will be applied as you move your image, just like that. All right, so let me just go and make it to the center, something like that. And this will be all. So that's how you create a glass morphism in Adobe Illustrator. So I hope that you enjoy and you like this tutorial, and it was a little bit helpful for you. If you try this, make sure to let me know or mention me wherever you want. And don't forget to subscribe and comment, and you know, wait for more tutorials to come. And have a nice day. Thank you for watching.